Good day, guys. Austin here. And in this one today, we're playing a few RPCS3 games. Now, in other words, we're playing PlayStation 3 games on our PC. Now, I asked you what games you wanted me to test, and this one was tip of the iceberg. So here we are. I've loaded it up. I'm using the latest build. I'll link the build in the description down below that I used. It's from the official website. It's not no hack, no slash, nothing like that. I'm loading it up. The only thing that I've ticked that's other than normal is that I've put right color buffers. That's it. Again, I'll link all that in the description, what I've actually done. Everything else is completely stock. And what I want to see is how far this has progressed right now. And already, a long way. Look at that. Jesus wept. So, from what I can see, the game's running what seems to be full speed, but we're obviously missing frames. At the moment, we're rendering 9 frames per second, but the game seems to be running full speed. That is a lot better than last time. Visually, this now looks nigh on perfect. Of course, we are running this at 720p, as the original game was. It seems that, I haven't tested it yet, but it seems that in the past, if I change the resolution, it just crashes all the time. This now looks not just nigh on perfect, but very stable as well. I haven't got much shader cache put into this, so I don't know how stuttery this will be, guys. As you can see now, I have tested this a few times, obviously, and I probably should have cleared my shader cache before I tested this now. But we're at the deep end. We live life on the edge. We're on the edge of my seat right now whilst I watch this unroll in front of my eyes. So sound is beautiful. Visually, it's looking beautiful, albeit 720p. We do live in the age where we can do at least 1080, but it has been a troublesome game in the past, so we have to live with our limitations. But this is such huge progress compared to last time. Huge progress. It also, if you look at the stats again on the top left-hand side of my screen, it is obviously taxing my system, more or less all cores, but it's not limiting my system. I'm only using 50% of my GPU, and I'd say on average, probably about 60 to 80% of my CPU. So I'm guessing the bottleneck at this point is in the emulator itself. Obviously expected, it's very early days, especially for this, which will be more than likely the holy grail of PlayStation 3 emulation. Now, when I've tested this in the past, I've grinned and birded it, spending about half an hour to get to this point. Obviously now we're running full speed, it's much better. But this is where it crashed. Is it going to get through? No, it doesn't seem to be the way. So it looks like we're still crashing in the same spot. Sometimes I can get further on with this. Sometimes I can progress further on the train journey, but it always seems to crash somewhere along the train journey, and it seems that one hasn't been overcome yet. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to smash on with a save game and see what it's like actually in-game playing it in all its glory.
5 minutes later.
Okay, so we're back in the game and now I can control it. Now, first off, I've got to say we are still hitting this terry bad frames per second. I mean, my specs are in the description down below, and from what I've seen on other people's gameplays, even in the past, it's around about the same speed. So I'm kind of guessing, now this is just hypothetical, but I'm guessing that it's the emulator itself which is bottlenecking, like I said earlier, because, I don't know, system for system, lower spec, higher spec, all seem to be getting around about the same frames per second, so there's gotta be a bottleneck somewhere. Now, let's have a mooch round anyway, let's see what's going down. I haven't got much shader cache done in this place, so there will be stutters from time to time, it's just the way it is. It's modern emulation, I'm afraid, the way that drivers work on GPUs, it just means that we've got to put up with the shader cache issue at this moment until someone comes up with a better idea how to cache them. Let's have a mooch round anyway. Let's see what's going on. We are running at 10 frames per second. I would say that we're no longer at 100 frames per second? No longer at 100% speed of the game. It is being slowed down by the the lag, I would suppose you'd say. Not so much the lag, but it's being slowed down by the skip frames. It seems that there's too many skip frames for it to actually keep on going at its 100% speed. But, hey, let's go into the saloon anyway. We'll see if it actually triggers the next part. I love this game. So many random things happen all the time. It's like Grand Theft Auto, isn't it? You could spend the whole game just having a mooch around the cities and stuff rather than playing through the quests. It's just Rockstar at the best. I'm hoping that the new one is actually as good as this. So here we go. It's the first time I triggered this, so there's no shade of catch at all for this. So you are seeing now what's going on in real time. I would say as well, the guys over at RPCS3, they have come on leaps and bounds with the, how would you say, the shader cache, the way that they're implementing this. So, to put it in layman's terms, from the way that I'm seeing it, basically, the game keeps on playing, and if the shaders aren't in the cache already, they will just load in the background. If that means that you're missing any of the textures, any of the assets on the screen, then so be it until they actually load in. It can make some quite comical intros, to be honest. When you actually load up a level and you wait for it all to load in around you. It's quite interesting with some games. Anyway, we digress. Now we're seeing speed hitting the normal. And now as we go outside again, we're drawing back. So again, this is probably due to the bottleneck somewhere within this emulator. Of course, again, it's easy for me to say that. It takes hours, days, months, years of research to get into some of what sometimes can be a simple case of flicking a switch somewhere and make it sound so easy. No, reverse engineering a console like the PS3, translating that into software, translating that into something which you can actually use on modern hardware nowadays, not native to the actual game itself, it's actually witchcraft. And the guys over at RPCS3, even to get to this stage, have overcome so much. It is unbelievable. The actual progress that has happened within this emulator over the last year has been absolutely remarkable. Each time there's a new development, which is almost by the day, there is new games working. There is new strides forward. Of course, there'll be lulls while they overcome certain, I don't know, issues within certain games where they implement new features which may become troublesome. There may even be regression with certain games. And I'm sure even this game right here, there is probably a build of the emulator which is far more compatible, giving you better frames per second and all that kind of good stuff. But for me, when I'm doing my tests on all these games and all these systems with all these emulators, I try to keep it to the most up-to-date, the most, well, basically the emulator that you guys would use if you was to download it right now. As in, no research, no nothing, you just want to play, see what happens. That's exactly what I'm doing right here. And hopefully it gives you the impression of what to expect when this kind of stuff happens. Sure, I'm kind of playing this to some people's standard on a supercomputer. And that is the way it is right now. PS3 emulation has a long way to go, a long journey. It has to start somewhere. And hopefully we can get to the stage where those system resources, the requirements, the minimum level to be able to emulate this system will decrease. Like we've seen with Citra, about 6 months ago you needed what, a 4 gigahertz processor to play 3DS games? Unbelievable. And within that 6 months they've managed to get it down to where you can almost play it on a ThinkPad. It's unbelievable the progress and the development that's made in these emulators. And all I can do is praise each and every one of them for the hard work, the dedication and the commitment to the cause, so we can play these games on whatever we want to play them on at whatever resolution, hopefully in the future, forever. But right now you're seeing what I've seen. Right now we've been catching up on Red Dead Redemption. I keep on saying 2, but it's not out yet. But now we are up to speed. I'm waffling on now, but I've got to say thank you to each and every one of my Patreon members. You make all this possible, going that extra stage further, contributing towards my scene, so hopefully I can bring it to everybody's scene. And I cannot thank you enough for everything that you've done to make this possible. So thank you very much to the emulator guys. Thank you very much to you guys. Please like, please subscribe, please do all the magical thing in this wonderful world where we get to play, hopefully, Red Dead Redemption very soon. But most of all, you guys have a good day. Laters!